Now, what we know definitely about the history of this is that back in 1955, Carolyn Bryant Donham falsely told her husband that the 14-year-old Till had touched her, essentially inciting the man and his brother to murder the child. And although Bryant Dunham's husband and brother were acquitted by an all-white jury back in the day, she has never faced any charges whatsoever or stood trial. And a Mississippi grand jury was considering whether to change that in terms of indicting her. This is a picture of Carolyn Bryant Donham. This woman here had played a role in the murder of Emmett Till, yet again manages to evade any kind of accountability as a Mississippi grand jury refused to indict. And this is what we know for the AP. After hearing more than 7 hours of testimony from investigators and witnesses, a Leflore County grand jury last week determined there was insufficient evidence to indict Carolyn Bryant Donham on charges of kidnapping and manslaughter. Leflore County District Attorney Dewayne Richardson said in a news release on Tuesday. And this latest attempt to seek justice, well, it was started when Till's family had unearthed an unserved arrest warrant for Bryant Donham, her late husband and his brother. The warrant is dated August 29th, 1955 and signed by the Leflore County clerk. The image of the warrant shows the current clerk certifying the document as authentic on June 21st. A note on the back of the warrant says Bryant Donham was not arrested because she could not be located at the time. And that is according to the New York Times, which cited filmmaker Keith Beauchamp, who was part of the team that discovered the warrant. Now, this grand jury decision, it really comes off the heels of this 87-year-old Donham, her unpublished memoir. She's essentially trying to rewrite history so that her legacy will be one of showing her as being altruistic. You know, it seems that in her memoir, she's claiming, she says, "I did not wish Emmett any harm and could not stop harm from coming to him since I did not know what was planned for him." Donham says in the unpublished manuscript, "I tried to protect him by telling Roy that he's not the one, that's not him, please take him home." Sure. Yeah, I'm sure. Now, for those wondering about the lack of federal government involvement in this case, the Justice Department said the statute of limitations has run out on any potential federal crime, but the FBI worked with state investigators to determine state charges. February 2007, a Mississippi grand jury declined to indict anyone, and the Justice Department announced that it was closing the case, but federal officials announced last year that they were once again closing their investigation, saying there was insufficient evidence to prove beyond a reasonable doubt that she lied to the feds. Oof, this is essentially, as far as I'm concerned, it's just another reflection of how the system is not here to address any of the ills that have been waged upon the black community. Emmett Till was murdered. He was a 14-year-old child visiting Mississippi from Chicago, and his body was torn apart and ravaged, and his mother had that open casket. It was something that was extremely memorable and seen by people that this is what happens. This is what white supremacy will do to a child who is lied on, and this woman played a role. As much as she would like to rewrite history, I will not allow that to happen. And it's so incredibly upsetting that we can't get any semblance of justice, especially when we see that there is no statute of limitations when it comes to murder. And also we see society continue to go after Nazis who have committed war crimes and who have done heinous things to people. So why Carolyn Bryant Donham gets a pass is beyond me. AB?
Yeah, it's really unfortunate that this has fallen by the wayside like this. When you think about the fact that this woman has admitted to what she's done, she wrote a whole book about what she did. Again, we have a 14-year-old boy who did not get justice. You know, he still has a mother who had to deal with this as well. And when you think about the fact that this went to a grand jury, which is one of the most private juries ever, right? Like, there's no defense there. So how do you not have enough sufficient evidence to prove beyond a reasonable doubt that this woman participated in this crime against this young boy? So it just makes you wonder, you know, what really happened in that grand jury room, again, because there's no transcripts or anything like that that we can get to at this point. But it's just unfortunate. And I think that, you know, we look at an old white woman in Mississippi and we see what the law is. And this is why we need to be way more involved in the laws that are being established and be way more active in trying to get laws changed, because she needs to see justice for what she did.
Absolutely, without a doubt. And the thing is when these historical aspects are not rectified, they continued to send a message today. They let us know as Black people that the harms that were waged upon us and continue to be harmed aren't deserving of justice, even though we see others around us who continue to get justice. And this is all, as far as I'm concerned, part and parcel with the talk about reparations. Again, it continues to say that what was done to you and what we're doing to you, that there's nothing worthy of justice, and you will never be worthy of justice. It's absolutely disgusting, and it's very upsetting as far as I'm concerned. But I really want to thank those who continue to pursue some kind of justice out there, and do not give up hope, because Carolyn Bryant Donham needs to be brought to justice.